There is nothing like a little fun in the sun. But I have a question for you. Did you know there is one day during the calendar year that is sunnier than the rest? If not, hang out with us as we take you to school.
Hey friend, I'm glad you stopped by, and today we are ready to take you to school with a few fun facts about Solstice. Now, I know a lot of people haven't heard of Solstice, so chill with us as we share interesting facts that you might not know.
Let's go, big sis. Now, we've talked about the name Summer Solstice, but why don't you tell our friend watching what Summer Solstice is?
I got you, little bro. Think about it for a second. There are certain days when the sun is out a long time. And then there are times when the sun may not be out as long.
Right, I'm with you.
This plays a big part in today's discussion about summer solstice. Summer solstice is also known as midsummer. This happens when the Earth's north-south axis is tilted towards the sun, allowing each hemisphere to receive more sunlight than on any other day of the year. During the June solstice, the midday sun is at its highest point in the sky for the northern hemisphere. What's crazy is over time, that height gets lower and lower as the Earth's tilt has slowly decreased.
Okay, it makes sense. So when we look at the June solstice, the northern hemisphere will have the longest day and the shortest night of the year. And on the flip side, the southern hemisphere will have the shortest day and longest night of the year. Is that right?
You got it, little bro. And how about you, my friend? I hope you are hanging in there with us.
I hope so, too. But, Bird, I do have a question.
Go ahead, little bro. What do you want to know?
Okay, so I know you said summer solstice happens in June. Is there a specific day that it happens?
Well, not a specific day, but you can count on the summer solstice showing up on the calendar in the month of June each year on certain days. That is where summer solstice always occurs between June 20th and June 22nd. Now, with the Earth shifting, we can't always give you the exact time that it's going to happen each year, but it will happen.
So, Bert, in the northern hemisphere, if the June solstice is the day that the sun shines the longest, does that make it one of the hottest days of the year?
Good question, little bro. And the answer would be no. Even though the solstice that happens in June has the most sun in the northern hemisphere, you have to remember that the Earth's ocean and atmosphere are like an oven. Just like it takes an oven a long time to heat up and also a long time to cool down. It's the same thing with the Earth. Even though the planet gets a ton of sunlight, it takes weeks for that to release on the planet, making the hottest days of the year normally fall somewhere in July or August. Does that make sense?
It does make sense. I guess that's why it gets hotter the deeper we get into summer.
You are right, little bro. And speaking of getting further into the summer, many people have different celebrations during summertime. But many cultures over history have also celebrated the summer solstice. For example, in ancient Egypt, Egyptians built the Great Pyramids so that the sun, when viewed from the Sphinx, landed right between the two of the pyramids there in Egypt.
I even read that in South America, they discovered a Mayan city in Guatemala that had buildings just like Egypt that aligned with the sun during the solstices.
Just looking around the world, there are many monuments that reference both winter and summer solstice. Looking to the United Kingdom, one of the largest tourist attractions in the world is Stonehenge. Stonehenge has been tied to the winter and summer solstice for thousands of years.
I hope you enjoyed hanging with us, and we'll see you next time, my friend.